the Packers running backs, NFL suspended Aaron Jones. Aaron Jones, who I picked up for the stretch run of my fantasy league title last year, and did okay for me, but didn't blow up like I'd hoped he would. He suspended 2 games for violating the league's substance abuse policy. You know, the guy likes his weed.
Yep, exactly. Right. Yeah, pretty obvious suspension coming. He pleaded no guilty to this a while ago. But what does it mean fantasy-wise? Obviously, Jones has to take a pretty significant bump down. Even though I love him the most in terms of talent for the Packers running backs, he was by far the most explosive guy last year. The only guy that really benefited from an offensive line that generated the most yards before contact. So they were paving great holes. But nobody else was really taking advantage of that outside of Aaron Jones, who averaged a ridiculous amount more of yards per carry on his than did the plodding Jamaal Williams, than did the pathetic Ty Montgomery up the gut. But ultimately, that doesn't matter if he's not going to be on the field. And when you look at an offense like the Packers, I think it's a huge risk to remove yourself out of those early games, because when you're in an Aaron Rodgers offense, that thing's going to churn. It's going to be a machine. It's going to work. Jamaal Williams is excellent in pass protection, which is what's pretty much most important for a Packers back to be solid at. So you look at all that. You imagine the Packers get off to a hot start. Why would they fix what's not broken? Sure, you hope they recognize, Mike McCarthy recognizes, that Aaron Jones can bring this offense to a new level and elevate everybody else's game too. But ultimately, if it's working, they're scoring 28 a game as they always do with Rodgers. Why would you remove? Why would you fix what's not broken, essentially? So ultimately, I give Jamaal Williams a pretty healthy bump up. I give Montgomery a solid bump up as well, with a more clearer lockdown on that pass catching role. And Jones definitely falls down the list. Williams now more of an upside flex play. He was kind of that shaky, who's getting the work, how's it going to be distributed. Now he becomes, with that role clarity, an upside RB3, in my opinion, a guy you can put in your flex and feel okay with. I mean, remember, this guy did absolutely wreck it down the stretch for fantasy. He crushed it. I owned him last year, and it wasn't pretty. He was getting tons of carries, 20, 25, a bunch of receptions, and really not doing a ton with it. But ultimately, the volume was enough to carry him. That volume won't be there with Aaron Rodgers, but the scores could still be there. And again, that pest protection is the most important. So I really like what Jamaal Williams could bring to the table at this point with Jones removed.
I mean, I agree with all that. It's very, very hard to argue with Jones taking a hit going down. But I want to remind you, and I'm sure I'm not telling you anything you don't know, running back position where health is never a guarantee. And we know that Aaron Jones is an explosive option. If you got, say, a 5 or 6, say you got a 6 running back limit thing on your roster, you know, picking up Aaron Jones and stashing him and throwing him in the last spot, if you can afford to do that, that might be something that really pays dividends down the road.
Oh, absolutely. I'm not saying he's undraftable. I think that's a great point, Nat. Like, he goes from a guy that I was targeting in round like 8 or 9 to a guy that, you know, his price is going to fall pretty significantly, I imagine. It's already 103 right now, which I think is going to take a pretty big leap forward, because Jamaal Williams is going at 99th overall. I imagine that's going to get a steady 12 to 20 or so picks up. And Aaron Jones will probably fall like 120, 130. I think that's going to be a good value. I mean, like you said, he brings a ton to the table. 5.5 yards per carry, led the NFL in terms of individual yards per carry versus team yard per carry differential. So, I mean, the guy brings by far the most to the table. Ripped off 15-plus yard runs on every 10.1 of his carries. Nobody else. Williams had one 15-plus one on 153 of his totes. So Jones had 6 of 20-plus yards, more than Le'Veon Bell, Leonard Fournette, and even Alvin Kamara on like a third of the works. I mean, the guy is incredibly explosive. You're right. Huge upside. I think, if anything, this just makes him, you know, a great stash along the Chubbs you talked about. Becomes an excellent stash at a much better price. Maybe this ends up helping Jones' fantasy stock because he becomes such a good value. It's a great point.